China reiterates it will not recognize the 2016 arbitral ruling, which already invalidated its sweeping claims in the West Philippine Sea. Beijing's foreign ministry said on Friday, China's attitude is legitimate and just. It added the international ruling should not be used by some countries to seek what it called selfish gains.
The arbitral tribunal in the South China Sea arbitration exercised its jurisdiction ultra vires and made an illegitimate ruling. The rendered award is illegal, null, and void. Any hypes that seek to mislead the public will fail. They will not turn the null and void award into a legal one, nor could they ever weaken China's firm resolve to defend our territorial integrity and maritime rights and interests.
Still on President Marcos's keynote speech at the Shangri-La Dialogue, he called on the world's two most powerful economies to manage their rivalry. Marcos asserts Washington and Beijing's dispute is destabilizing for the Asia-Pacific region. China and the U.S. have been battling for influence in the region, especially on issues over the South China Sea and Taiwan.
We need to begin by resoundingly rejecting misguided interpretations that paint our region as a mere theater of geopolitical rivalries. We are not mere bystanders to unfolding world events. We are the actors that drive those events. We are the main characters in our collective story. We are the owners of the narratives. It's never a choice. Both countries are important. The continued stability of this region requires China and the United States to manage that rivalry in a responsible manner. This rivalry is constraining the strategic choices of regional states. This contest is exacerbating flashpoints and has created new security dilemmas.
Amid the growing tensions, Beijing and Washington's defense chiefs met on the sidelines of the Shangri-La Dialogue to navigate security issues in the Asia-Pacific. That was their first in-person meeting since 2022. Now, while Marcos was in Singapore, he delivered the keynote speech at the International Institute for Strategic Studies' Shangri-La Dialogue, becoming the first Philippine leader to do so. Let's get the highlights from our correspondent Pia Gutierrez, joining us from Singapore. Pia.
Yes, Ricky, the Philippines will not yield amid growing tensions in the West Philippine Sea. That strong statement coming from President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. as he took the stage Friday night in Asia's top defense and security forum in Singapore. In front of the world's top military and defense officials, including a high-level contingent from China, President Marcos said he will do whatever it takes to protect his sovereign home, saying that the country's maritime claims have been affirmed by international law.
So the lines that we draw on our waters are not derived from just our imagination, but from international law. We have on our side the 1982 UNCLOS and the binding 2016 arbitral award, which affirms what is ours by legal right. In this solid footing and through our clear moral ascendancy, we find the strength to do whatever it takes to protect our sovereign home. To the last square inch, to the last square millimeter.
Without directly naming China, the president called out what he calls aggressive actions that continue to violate the Philippines' rights in the resource-rich waterway.
We cannot allow anyone to detach it from the totality of the maritime domain that renders our nation whole. As president, I have sworn to this solemn commitment from the very first day that I took office. I do not intend to yield. Filipinos do not yield.
In the forum, Marcos warned China that the Philippines will respond accordingly should any willful action lead to the death of any Filipino in the West Philippine Sea, saying that such will come very close to an act of war.
If a Filipino citizen is killed by a willful act, that is, I think, very, very close to what we define as an act of war. And therefore, we will respond accordingly. We already have suffered injury, but thank God, we have not yet gotten to the point where any of our participants, civilian or otherwise, have been killed. But once we get to that point, That is certainly, we would have crossed the Rubicon, certainly crossed the Rubicon. Is that a red line? Almost certainly it's going to be a red line.
The president's speech is expected to set the tone of discussions in the forum happening this weekend in Singapore. Other notable speakers of the forum include U.S. Defense Secretary Lloyd Austin and Chinese Defense Minister Dong Jun, as well as AFP Chief of Staff Romeo Browner Jr. and Philippine Coast Guard Commandant Admiral Ronnie Gavan. According to reports, Rika, Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky may also make an appearance to speak in the forum. Rika?
Thank you so much, Pia Gutierrez, reporting live. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. now back in the Philippines following his back-to-back trips from Singapore and Brunei. In his arrival message, Marcos called his trips productive and engaging. During his first state visit to Brunei, the chief executive forged deals on tourism, agriculture, and maritime cooperation in a bid to address the two countries' overlapping claims in the South China Sea. He also discussed the country's push for renewable energy with top oil and gas firms in Brunei. Meanwhile, Marcos highlighted the country's position in the West Philippine Sea during his working visit in Singapore. He also met with the city-state's new leaders. Marcos vows to build on the gains of his successful trips to advance the Philippines' economic and security agenda.
While in Brunei, our key government players and business sector engaged in productive dialogue with their counterparts. In Singapore, I met with the leaders of the country, namely President Tharman Shanmugaratnam and newly appointed Prime Minister Lawrence Wong. The deep bonds of friendship between our countries are evident in all our conversations. The President has already graced our invitation for him to visit and is planning a visit to our country in August. My promise to all Filipinos, we will use every opportunity and continue to build bridges that will ensure a long-lasting peace and stability in our region.
One of France's biggest warships docks in Manila for a five-day port call. The destroyer ship Bretagne is part of the French Navy's routine mission to demonstrate freedom of navigation. The visit is also among those included in the letter of intent signed between Manila and Paris in December. The two countries have been wrapping up defense cooperation following Paris's inaugural participation in Manila and Washington's maritime exercises in the West Philippine Sea. The Philippines and France have also begun talks for a possible visiting forces agreement that would enable troops from the two countries to conduct joint training and larger exercises. A measure seeking to clear streets of dangling and unused overhead cables has been filed at the House of Representatives. Vivian Gulia with the details.
These sagging overhead spaghetti wires along Sauyo, Quezon City have been a cause for concern among passing motorists and nearby residents.
Kasi pag sumabit sa truck yan, baka may pag maputol, pag may live yon, baka matamaan yung tao, makurinte.
May clip yan. Dahil ano, kumisay abot sa semento. Eh di ba delikado sa motor yon ay pagka mabilis ang takbo at sumabit, ay di madidisgrasya yung nakamotor.
Even along some major roads, there are dangling and non-operational cables that pose a risk to the public. A proposed measure filed before the House of Representatives seeks to address this problem. House Bill 10427 mandates public utility providers, including power, telecommunication, cable, and internet providers, to bundle up aerial utility wires, remove all non-operational or unused wires and cables, and relocate or replace posts to adhere with a specified allowable clearance for aerial wires and cables. The bill authorizes local government units to withhold or cancel the permits of providers that will fail to comply. Bulacan 6th District Representative Salvador Pleito, who authorized the measure, says these unsightly and accident-prone overhead cables have been the subject of several local ordinances, but the problem persists. The Manila Electric Company welcomes the measure, adding that it has ramped up efforts to fix sagging and non-operational wires. Meralco, however, says they are also affected by the cables of other service providers, which are illegally connected to their posts.
Ito yung mga ibang service providers na kung minsan hindi nagpapaalam sa Meralco. That is illegal. At aside from informing us, get us secure a permit from the local government unit. Diba? Hindi yung ilalatag lang tapos yung iba iniiwanan.
PLDT, for its part, assured the public that it is conducting a cleanup drive to recover old cables no longer needed in areas where customers have upgraded to fiber. The telco firm adds the drive complies with congressional bills and LGU ordinances requiring utility companies to tidy up streets of sagging cables and tilting poles. Metro Manila Council President and San Juan City Mayor Francis Zamora expressed support for the House bill, adding that the MMC will also discuss in its next meeting measures against so-called spaghetti wires.
The MMC can also pass a resolution calling on the telcos to undertake measures to ensure the safety of everyone by way of removing wires na deemed useless or unnecessary upang siguraduhin na makaiwas tayo sa anumang sakuna.
Three bills are also pending at the House committee level, seeking to relocate underground the wire and cable systems of public utility providers. Vivian Gulia, ABS-CBN News.
Diesel prices see to head higher for a second straight week. Estimates show in the first week of June, motorists would have to pay at least 40 centavos more for a liter of diesel. Gasoline, meanwhile, could go down by as much as 1 peso and 10 centavos per liter. The prices of kerosene also seem to go down by at least 60 centavos per liter.